How were files recovered that I thought were deleted? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is a kind of spooky one if it catches you by surprise. Let's get right to the question. My son brought up some files in my computer that I had deleted, such as emails in my Yahoo account, deleted photos, and deleted conversations on Yahoo Messenger. How is this possible? And where do I go in my computer to get rid of that information? And how do I prevent this from happening again? It's long been one of those rules of thumb that we often grasp at, that deleted isn't really deleted. Until, of course, you need something that's been deleted and you can't get it back. But the bottom line is that deleting for a variety of reasons and in a variety of places doesn't always mean that things are completely and irretrievably deleted. Let's look at a couple of different ways that various things might not have really been deleted, even though you said to delete them. One of the things that can happen, of course, is that you might assume that there's a delete going on, but it's not. One of the examples, the best example I have of this that continues to surprise people all the time, is your web browser cache. When you visit websites, the web browser downloads the page, the images, the whatevers from the various pages that you visit, and it places them in what's called a cache. When you go on to visit another page, those files aren't deleted. They're left there on purpose, actually. A good example would be the logo on askleo.com. When you visit one page, the first page you visit downloads the logo. When you visit another page that has the same logo on it, there's no need to download it again. It's a very important speed enhancement that allows you to view pages much quicker than if the browser needed to download everything over and over and over again. Now, how things get deleted from the cache is kind of mysterious because it depends on how big the cache is, which browser you're using, how many pages you've been visiting, all that kind of stuff. The intent is that the browser deletes the old stuff automatically when it needs to make room for newer things. Again, that can be sometimes a little difficult to put a brain around because when you take a look at what you've been looking at, things you think might have been old aren't, things that might be new get deleted. It gets complicated pretty quickly. And of course, when you empty your cache manually, then those things really are deleted. The scenario where this comes up that surprises the most people is when they actually have a picture that they've downloaded, they happen to manage to browse into their cache where they're looking at photographs, and all of a sudden, all these old photos that they've seen before from browsing the web days, months, weeks ago, suddenly reappear as they're browsing, as they're looking around on their hard disk. So clearing your cache is one example. I have to say it's just one example because honestly, all sorts of different programs may do similar things and may actually not delete things when you think they might be deleted. It's kind of up to whatever that program decides is the most efficient for how it gets used. Remember, deleting something means if you need that something, you need to get it again. That's why the browser cache is a speed improvement. But for other programs doing other things, there may be other reasons for them to at least defer deleting the kinds of things that you might otherwise think are deleted. Now, one of the more obvious examples of things not being deleted when you literally say delete is the recycle bin. By definition, when you in Windows File Explorer delete a file, it gets moved to the recycle bin instead of being deleted. What that means is that if you change your mind, which is an incredibly common thing to have happen, you can simply go to the recycle bin and recover your file. That's why the recycle bin exists. So one way to make sure that things are really deleted is to either not use the recycle bin. In other words, you can like shift delete instead of delete, and it'll bypass the recycle bin. You can turn the recycle bin off, or more commonly, you can simply empty the recycle bin once in a while when you know you need to make sure that there's nothing in it. Now, even so, Even so, and this is the one that I think that a lot of people hang a lot of hope on when they accidentally delete a file, is that when you delete a file in Windows and many other operating systems, the data for that file is not overwritten. In other words, basically a pointer to the file, something that says, hey, the data for this file, foo.txt, is over there. Well, the pointer goes away, the name foo.txt goes away, but that data is still over there. What that means is that recovery programs can sometimes, understanding the way disks are laid out, go back and reconstruct the file from the data that remains on the disk. The only way to deal with this is to use what's called a secure delete program that actually makes sure to not just delete the file, the pointer to the file, but actually overwrite the data. Or after you've deleted a number of files, use what's called a free space wiper, because the data that used to be the file is now available for other files to overwrite, and it remains there until they do. It's in free space. What a free space wiper does is it literally goes and writes data in all of the unused area of your hard disk so that no files can be recovered using these kinds of mechanisms. Something people miss all the time: the file was backed up. In other words, you deleted the file on Tuesday, but you forgot that, oh yeah, Monday's backup of my machine is going to have a copy of that file. For better or for worse, in other words, sometimes it's a safety net that allows you to get a deleted file back. Sometimes it's an embarrassment when a deleted file comes back to haunt you. But the bottom line is that backups need to be factored into all of this for sure. Backups do contain old copies of the files, and they're around as long as the backups themselves are kept. So when it comes to making sure that gone is gone, you do need to understand how the programs you use deal with deleting things that they may or may not delete immediately. The browser cache being one example, but many other programs fall into this category. Empty the recycle bin. To make sure that things are gone, every so often, empty the recycle bin. That makes it non-trivial to get the file back. You really need to know that you don't want it back ever, but it is a very quick and very easy thing to do. And finally, if you really are concerned about files that have been truly deleted, emptied from the recycle bin, deleted in other ways, then make sure to run a free space wiper or to delete those sensitive files using a secure delete tool. Now, whenever I have a discussion about data recovery, deleted files and such, I also have to at least talk about what I call further incantations to raise the dead. The thing is, especially on magnetic media, it may be possible, even if we've done all the things we've talked about, for what I'll refer to as advanced forensic data recovery techniques to be able to recover some or all of the information that's been deleted from a hard disk. It's rare. Becoming rarer because it's much harder on SSDs. But the bottom line is that magnetic media sometimes can leave traces even of erased files. Now, to be clear, this is not easy. In fact, it's expensive, and it typically involves taking a hard disk to a clean room and taking it apart and using special equipment to analyze the data that's on that disk. But for completeness, I do have to point out that this is one of those things that can, in some cases, come back to haunt some people. The solution, by the way, to dealing with this is twofold. You have two choices. One is overwrite the data multiple times, because that's what makes it difficult to do. You'll take a look at some of the disk space or disk wiping software, and they'll actually give you a choice. Do you want me to overwrite this once or five times or 30 times? Couple of times is plenty, trust me on that. But bottom line is, you can say overwrite this multiple times. The other approach that is surprisingly easy and surprisingly transparent is to use whole disk encryption. Because once a disk is encrypted, it doesn't matter if they can recover the bits. They still won't be able to decrypt them. So something like BitLocker or VeraCrypt or any of the others that support a whole disk encryption format, those are also great ways to ensure that the data won't come back from the dead to surprise you at some point in the future. Hope that was helpful. For updates, for related links, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/3661. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.